友達になってからジェイクが次に作りたいゲームの話をしていて、こんな感じなんだよ、こんな感じなんだよっていう話を、まだその本当にジェイクの中にしかない頃から聞いてて、それだったらまあ俺は割と得意な方だなという、あんまりストレスがない感じの仕事になれるなと思ったんで、時間を作っていつでも書くよみたいな話はしてたんですね。でそこから始まって、で実際動き始めて、年に何回か京都に行って2人でミーティングしながら、こんな感じこんな感じ、だからゲームのその細かいところももう決まってない状態でイメージをこっちから出していくっていうような作業と、あとまあアイデアも俺が思いついたで使ってもらえるんだったらこういうアイデアもあるよみたいなところで、こうだんだんこう核が出来上がっていくっていう、でやってるうちに割と行くたびにこう新しい世界に変わっていってるのは、こっちも割とエキサイティングな感じで楽しかった仕事ですね。
Toronto-san has such a unique vision. Like, I'll ask him for something. I'll ask for a broad stroke. Like, we need this shaman woman in this tent. And, you know, I have a vision of what that might be. And then he'll inevitably come back with something I never even considered before. And it's super unique. It's original. It's dark. But it's super memorable. And it's super amazing and a perfect fit for the project. So we've been so lucky to have these influences just kind of constantly being drip-fed in.And always finding a perfect home for them. And there's been a lot of stuff that's come in just completely. He's just like, I was noodling around, and I had an extra hour, and I did this weird thing. And we're like, that's going in the game. I don't know how. I don't know what it is. It's going in the game because it's amazing. And so we have these cool, really unique elements in the game that are only a byproduct of his creative vision and his amazing random stuff that he'll just deliver on us. We're like, yep, that's going in the game.
とりあえず最初はあんまり何かに限定しないで、出せる出せないも気にしないで、とにかくそこにいるだろう動物を描くとか、そこにあるだろう世界を描くとか、そういうところを求められたらスケッチするで渡すっていう作業をしてましたね。だから俺はそんなにこれは考えたっていうよりは、まあジェイクの言葉をちょっとすくい上げながら具現化していく作業で、それを見てジェイクの考えがまた固まっていくっていう、
We were trying to kind of decide. I mean, you can say caveman, you can say primitive man, but what does that mean? Like, is it Asia, Africa, Europe? You know, what does that mean? And so we kind of settled in on the original Asians to leave Asia to come over to the New World and kind of, you know, over the Bering Strait. We kind of decided loosely on that as being sort of our timeline. And so he's able to just sort of.Provide such a depth, such a richness to the culture, the clothing, the types of tools they would build. I didn't know he was so aware of this stuff. I don't know why he knows all this stuff. I guess it's his job as a creative designer to just, you know, have a really strong grasp on history and the history of tools and the history of hunting and like all these things. And so he was constantly just bringing these new elements to the table that made perfect sense and yet were unique and kind of his own flavor. You know, he has his own kind of really weird flavor, this really beautiful, gritty life and death motif that really kind of runs through all of his work. And it just slotted perfectly into the story that we're trying to tell and really helped us form kind of the goal of the whole project, where we were going to take this thing thematically, what this world would look like, what these characters would feel like, and how to sort of incorporate them into this broader world.
個人的にはファイティングするゲームすごい好きなんですけれども、そのやっぱり人間みたいなものが世界に対してすごく小さいで、その小さいけどみんなそこで頑張って生きていかなきゃいけないみたいなところが基本姿勢としてはすごいあって、派手じゃないけど、まあ、人生こんな感じだよねみたいな、そういうところはすごく考え方はちょっと近いところがあるし、もともとまあジェイクの口からよく出てくるその京都への愛とかね、日本の古い建物が好きとか、その感覚的にはすごい近いところがいっぱいあって、原始的な世界を見る目線も割とその近いところにあった気がするので、そこら辺も含めて入りやすかったっていう感じがあります。